Hi, in this video, we'd like to quickly summarize some of the new features that come out with NoseBe 3.1 and 3.2. Comments view. The most noticeable changes are in the comments view. Now you can create a task from a single comment. It's very useful when new ideas pop into your mind during a conversation. In the very same view, you can pin a comment to the top of the comments list, which will make sure you're focused on what's really essential in that task. You can also edit your attachment's description whenever you need to. The last new feature is copy to clipboard. This copies the whole comment with its markdown formatting. When you click this icon in the task details view, you can clone a task with all its parameters and comments. The clone task will always be delegated to you. Weekly productivity reports. In NoseBe 3.0, we introduced weekly productivity reports. Once enabled, we send them every week to motivate you. Here's what they look like. Time for some math about the NoseBe ratio. Add together all of your completed, delegated, and deleted tasks. Divide this by the number of tasks added and delegated to you. Then multiply by 100% and there you go, your weekly NoseBe ratio. New popovers. This is huge! What is a popover? Just click plus to add a new project and there it is. A new window. A popover pop-up. Now you can add multiple parameters to the project during the creation process. You have everything in one place. Let's change some parameters in a task. When you click on one of the parameters and use your keyboard arrows, you can browse through the possible options, then accept it by pressing Enter. You can also use keyboard shortcuts to access task parameters and then use the quick search bar. Let's press Shift, Command, P on a Mac to change the project of this task. Now hit the first few letters of the project name and press Enter. You can find all keyboard shortcuts for Windows and Mac on our help page. Just visit nosebe.com/help. If you can accept an invitation to join a project, you can quickly add a label and color to it. This has improved the process of customizing your app. Last but not least is our date and time picker. We redesigned it so you can choose a date and a time for your task more accurately and faster. It works even better on mobile devices. Quick Add for OS X. If you use the Quick Add for OS X, you'll notice a change. It looks great on the new version of the system. All hashtag parameters and comments are more accessible than ever. Use it to quickly capture your ideas. By the way, there is also a quick way to add a task on OS X that is not related to the Quick Add feature. Just drag and drop a file on the NoseBe icon in your dock and look what happens. A new task in your inbox appears with a file attached to it. Try it. Improved task swipes. We've made our task swipes better. Go to the settings on your mobile device, tap on General and choose the actions for your swipes. There is one new action available. From now on, you can go to the project of a task directly from your priority list. Better notifications. NoseBe 3.1 introduced some cool changes in notifications. When you receive an invitation to a project, you can accept it or decline from your notification bar. Quick and easy. When someone mentions you in a comment, you can add this task to your priority list. This way you can save that comment for later without forgetting about it. You can also mark a task as done if someone delegates it to you. One more thing about notifications. With NoseBe 3.2, you can snooze them on your iOS device. You will be notified again 15 minutes later. Minor changes. Now let's have a look at a few minor changes that you've asked for. In NoseBe 3.0, we added the keyboard assistant on iPhone. The same assistant is now available on iPad. We've also gone a step ahead in the login experience. With the most recent update, we will let you log in with your Google account. In NoseBe 3.2, we added the option to log in with the 1Password app. iCloud keychain method was also improved. If you have task details open, you can close them by clicking on a button that we introduced in NoseBe 3.0. Now you can also click on the toolbar, status bar, or any space below the task list. In the search section, you can remove your search history with the Clear History button. There are also some improvements in the Templates section. Now you can add colors and icons. These aren't all of the changes that we've introduced in Nosby 3.1 and 3.2. We encourage you to visit our blog at nosby.com/blog to find more about us. You're also more than welcome to subscribe to this channel on YouTube. Thanks for watching. Have a nice and productive day with Nosby.